Hey everybody, welcome back to Magic Orthodoxy. My name's David, and this is a deck review. Hey, today we are gonna look at three different decks, actually. This is the Neo Wave series from Montenzi Design. This was a Kickstarter, a really interesting Kickstarter, actually, because there were four decks made off of this one simple pattern. So there's this deck, this was the Neo Wave Classic, and these were printed from United States Playing Card Company. Then there was this deck, which is the Neo Wave Ultra. There were two of these printed, both done in foil, both from Cardamundi. And then there was this deck, which is the Neo Wave Ultra Players Edition, not foil, also printed by Cardamundi. So I have three out of the four decks, all generously given to me by Montenzi Design. They are based out in New Zealand, and big props to New Zealand. Lots of cool decks coming out of New Zealand. And if you want to learn more about them, you can always visit montenzi.nz, and I will put links all throughout. I'm gonna show you all three tuck cases right now. They do all say Neo across the top. The classic edition is done in a blue with orange accents. It's an anchor, you have an anchor symbol, and it's kind of accented by these four pointed stars. Underneath on the blue one, it does say it's the Wave Classic Edition. And there really isn't a lot of other scripting on the box other than the ad copy at the bottom. Now the Ultra came in two different colors, but you can see that there's like this beautiful foil going on, but then also like a transition like gradient color, like it moves from a darker color to a lighter. So in this case, it moves from like a purple color to an orange. It does say Ultra down in the corner, and again, not a lot of scripting on this box at all. The last one is the Player's Edition. This is kind of like a marriage of the previous two. So there's no foil on this, just like the Classic Edition, but it has the Ultra design, and we're gonna see more of that on the faces. But again, the box is pretty plain. It does say Neo Wave on the sides, but again, no scripting, except for a little bit of ad copy way down on the backside. So that's pretty much it for these tuck cases. Let's take a look at these cards. Let's talk about stock and finish real quick. All three decks are printed on thick stock. So even the bicycle deck, between the bicycle deck and then the two Cardamundi decks, these are all done on a thicker stock. The Classic Edition is done on a casino grade stock, and then the two Cardamundi decks are done on their true linen B9 stock. And of course, I would think the foil adds a little bit of thickness as well, but you can see all the measurements there. The back design on the Classic Edition has a white border. That's pretty much gonna be your main difference between this deck and the other two. There's no foil on the back of this one, and the other two are full bleeds and go straight to the edge. But it's a really interesting back design that's kind of all broken up into these squares. You have these kind of like organic dancing diamond shapes, the orange star there and the anchors. Your Ultra and your Ultra Players Edition back designs are gonna be completely the same. The only difference is the Players Edition doesn't have foil. And that's really the main difference you're gonna see between these two. I'll show you both so that you can just see, but you can imagine, you know, one has foil and the other one doesn't. The back design on this is more of a casino back where the design goes all the way to the edge. Those stars aren't broken up with white borders, but you still have the four-pointed orange star and the anchor design. The Classic Edition faces are also different from the other decks. The Joker is a repeating image of the anchor, and it does say Joker there in the center. One Joker is more of a blue-green, and the other one is more of a red-orange. And then the faces of all your cards have kind of like a white border. The black suits have that blue-green watermark, like fingerprint pattern in the background, and the red suits have the burgundy watermark in the background. You're gonna have original pips and indices throughout, but they're still in a recognizable format and would be easy for gameplay. Your classic Ace of Spades simply says Neo Wave, and it has a beautiful spade pip there in the center. And your court cards are gonna be the same throughout all three decks, however, just the way that they're done will be a little different, but the characters are the same. And the way Montenzi does their court cards is really beautiful. So they all have large heads and shoulders, no hands, no weapons, hats. Kings a lot of times have facial hair, and everybody is forward facing. The other interesting thing is that they are not two-way patterns. You'll notice that the shoulders, you can usually see some sort of accent around the shoulders. You can see a difference from one end to the next. Also, the head pieces are not the same either, so the crowns and the things that are on their heads, like one side looks like it's a hat and the other side looks like it's just hair. Also with each deck, you're gonna get the same two gaff cards. You're gonna get a double backer, and you'll get a double-ended Court card, which has a queen on one end and a king on the other. Now with the Ultra deck and the Ultra Players Edition, there's a couple of extra things you're going to note. For instance, we said that the back design was a full bleed. Well, the faces are also a full bleed. You have a purple color that pushes all the way to the edges. The other thing you will notice, these cards are quad pipped. So you have a pip in every single corner. You're gonna have the same court cards, same pips and indices as the previous. However, everything is floating in the center with no frame. The other thing that's different between the Ultra and the Ultra Players Edition are the jokers. In these, you'll have a diptych. That means two cards that come together to make a picture of the anchor pattern. So if you stick them both together, it'll make the anchor, and it's made up of a red, orange, and a green, and kind of like a turquoise color. But as far as how these decks feel and handle, of course, Bicycle and Cardamundi make great stock. If you already own the B9 finish, you probably know how these cards feel. And of course, the Bicycle cards are a quality one control deck. Plus, they also are traditionally cut. So I think a lot of people will definitely like these cards. Again, I want to thank Montenzi Design and everybody down there for allowing me to have these cards so that I could do the review for you. Again, this is the Neo Wave all foil playing cards. And if you want to learn more about these cards, or purchase them for yourself, I would head on down to montenzi.nz. Thanks, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye.